First, I'll take, sir, your query, which you asked earlier. Can we have a separate rate, separate methods for one organization? This is example of Reliance. Your query was, is it allowed? For fixed assets, they are using WDV. But for crude oil, SLM. For one more asset, 100% depreciation in first year. For another one, iski life jyada hai, SLM. So even one organization can have a separate rates, can have a separate useful life, can have a separate method allowed in. Law or AS never stops that. I'll pick up the major issues. Second, ek point mere paas aaya, which was a very good point. Bilkul sir. Notes to accounts mein aayega sir. Even accounting policies you can specify. Yes.
Policy.
Certainly sir, bilkul.
To usko to declare karna padega usme.
There was one good query. Sir, let's suppose we have given an advance to a supplier, CPWD. This is known as your capital advance of 100 rupees. Logically, your bank must have decreased by 100. Jab unhone payment kara hoga, to guaranteed yahan se 100 minus ho gaya hoga. I'll raise two queries which was asked. They were good points. Now, the question was, from which date we should transfer this to capital work in progress? Because it's an advance. From which date we should start putting in CWIP, and from which date we should charge to fixed asset? Logically, very simple, it's an advance. Even we do it at our home also. If we have given the advance, unless the person has started the work, we don't capitalize it. When after 1 year, 2 years, he will give you a certificate ki itna maine kaam kar diya hai, then you transfer to CWIP. Then there was a query, sir, how we can say how much work has been completed? It is very clearly given in AS-7, construction contracts. It says, if you cannot calculate the actual cost, but you're given the advance, logically first he will be using your advance to create the asset. And if the project is for, let's say 10 months, and you've given the advance on, let's assume, 1st November 05, then by 31st March 06, you have your 5 months, 5 months out of 10 months have been used. You know, logically, you will go to the site. If substantial work has been done on time basis, 5 by 10, at least we can assume that 50% work has been completed. So 50% ko aap advance se remove karke, you can transfer to CWIP. Sir, I agree. The same thing I raised it. Maine unhe yahi kaha. I said ki CPWD, whatever it is, they must be giving a certificate. In that, they must be writing ki how much work has been done. If, let's suppose, even it's not available, then this method is permissible under AS-7. It means, now if I prepare a balance sheet on 31st March 06, I'll write CPWD advance 50% and CWIP, capital work in progress, 50%. And jab pura ready ho jayega, it will transfer to fixed asset. Haan ji sir, please. Very good, sir. 100% work done. Accounts? Sir, agreed. If 100% work has been done, so they must be issuing some certificate to you, no? Sir, agar 100, nahi, how would you say that 100% work is done? Right, sir.
We should know that what progress has been achieved, and we should also know that what has been completed.
sir, please, auditor, accountant never goes by the intuition. They always go by the paper. I know that I will be getting a property useless.
On the other hand, security is saying in writing that work has been completed, but the account are under possession, final account are under
possession. Sir, please, even accounts takes time. Balance sheet is prepared by May, but you still prepare your balance sheet, your trial by 31st March, right? Accounts may be rendered later, but if they have given a certificate that 100% work is completed, right? It means immediately how much cost has been incurred, wo usme likha hoga guaranteed. Immediately that cost you can transfer to CWIP.
When given certificate, they are just intimating.
Sir, I'm not saying to fix asset, I'm saying CWIP. When they issue the clearance certificate to you.
CWIP means the work in progress in CPWD that right. May be the building.
Right. And when you they issue you the clearance certificate, then you transfer entire CWIP to fixed asset. I know even 100% work done, sir. But sir, normal hai, jab tak clearance nahi milega. You cannot start, sir. It happens in lot of pollution plants everywhere. Plant is ready. Right. But until unless you get a clearance, you can't execute your plant. You cannot. Car you purchase it, until a car is transferred in your name. You can never run the car on your road. You run it, but if you get stuck, you will be charged a penalty. New car mein jab number plate nahi milta hai, you always put a piece of paper as a number. So jab tak clearance nahi milega, you can't charge it. Never. Next, the good point which was asked here, this I am raising to you guys. I will not explain this. It's a query which was asked. Let's suppose a grant is received for 1.4 crores. This is a grant. And asset has been purchased for 2 crores. And the balance sheet already has some opening balance. Let's say 10 crores. The query is how to treat this. How you guys are doing it right now, we have also discussed before the break. Chocolates are waiting, and after the lunch, the dessert was not as good. So you can have good chocolates here. Yes, sir. In balance sheet, 2 crores, sir?
Need no cash.
You are explaining gross or net?
Yes, gross.
Gross approach, okay. Okay, asset 2 crores, sir, right? Then, yes, ma'am. Bank will reduce by?
Is 0.6 crore.
Bank will decrease by 0.6?
Yes.
Perfect, ma'am. Now what? Maybe completely, ma'am, balance sheet match nahi hui
hai.
Capital fund will be added by?
1.4.
But balance sheet is not telling.
No, sir.
Let's go step by. Oh. Let's go step by step. It was a query from one of the institution. Bank opening 10 crores, capital fund 10 crores. And we have received a grant of 1.4 and 1.2. Now, ma'am, tell me.
Yeah, depreciation will be charged.
Oh, ma'am, forget about depreciation. First, tell me the asset. You're right. Aap bilkul sahi bol rahe. Chocolate wait kar rahi hai, ma'am. Bilkul sahi hai.
Bank amount will be deducted by 2 crore.
Okay, sir.
And asset will mention for 2 crore.
Okay, sir.
Now, balance is tally.
Okay, now what? Next step?
Depreciation.
Okay. First, if I am preparing this by net, then you tell me the balance sheet.
We will charge 1.4 as depreciation.
Okay, full amount, right? It means this becomes 9.4.
9.4. 9.4.
9.4 bank, right?
Yes.
Capital fund is 10 crores. Now net approach.
No, bank will be 10.
Soch lijiye, sir.
Yes, bank will be 10.
Okay.
And then depreciation will be on 0.6 on net approach.
So bank to rahega 9.4. You have received a...
Yes. Sorry, assets.
Right. Up together. Perfect.
0.6.
Perfect.
And then depreciation.
Perfect. Income expenditure.
Depreciation on right. 0.6.
Let's suppose 10%, I take it. Bilkul theek hai, sir. Perfect. This is a net approach. Perfect. But their auditor is raising the objection to this. What auditor is saying, you have been following gross approach for all the assets. This is the first time in your history that you are getting some partial grant, not 100%. And therefore, you should follow a net approach for this. Then that institute was in a confusion, can we follow for some asset gross and for some asset net? Tell me, yes or no? I hope the question is clear. No one stops you, sir, first of all, no one stops you. Okay. It means if gross has to be followed for everything gross, okay. Otherwise, reason, sir. Sir, please remember, auditors ko reason dena padega aapko. Aur tabhi wo memos issue karte hain.
Same procedure should be followed, either net or gross. Otherwise, depreciation calculation will be affected. So,
for simplified, I agree with your approach. Ye sab mein same lagna chahiye. But no one stops, first of all. AS never says ki iske liye is a separate asset. So you can have a separate policy for it. Wo galat nahi hai. But I agree, simplified approach mein jana hai. To simplified mein sab mein ek hi lagao.
No, sir, the following procedure, consistency should be there.
I agree, I'm not denying that. But it's a new asset. So if the same thing has to be done for the gross, who will tell the same thing for the gross? Bank, 10 crores, capital fund, 10 crores. Again, chocolate waiting. Yes, sir, aapko chocolate mil gaya. Girl cheating, ye ji. Aapko nahi. Chocolate mil chuka hai aapko. Someone else. The same thing with a gross approach. Yes.
Then sir,
piche.
Sir, grant 1.4 crore capital fund.
Capital fund is a grant?
Grant 1.4 crore.
Right, sir.
Bank 1.4 crore.
Perfect, sir.
Then sir, asset purchase 2 crore.
Brilliant, sir.
Then asset 2 crore.
Brilliant.
Sir.
I'm repeating this again, sir, because this is the major point where we get stuck. I'm taking a lot of examples for this. Sir.
Then, sir, then bank reduced to 9.4 crore asset. 2
perfect,
crore.
Sir, perfect. Bank is 9.4, brilliant.
11.4 crore, and this capital fund is also 11.4.
Right,
crore.
It means my new balance sheet will have bank 9.4,
asset 2,
perfect, ma'am, 10.
Sir, then.
And grant?
1.4.
Right, now what, sir?
Then, sir, depreciation charge, then depreciation.
Brilliant, sir. Brilliant. 10%, sir.
10%.
Right,
then,
sir.
0.2. 0.2 depreciation.
Right.
Then it will be reduced, sir, from asset and from
right.
capital.
The approach which you guys are following, you are taking as a deficit and subtracting it. Or what I mentioned to you, you can even take it as a?
Deferred.
That's the best way, because it will classify separate. 0.2 grant.
0.2.
Brilliant. Perfectly fine. Sir. Another query. And I am happy those queries are all related to AS-6 or AS-10. Now tell me one more query. There was a query that in 1961, let me take a calendar year, easy. In 1961, there was some building was purchased. Let's suppose for 100. For these years, no depreciation has been charged. Now you want to show in your balance sheet this asset. This asset is coming at 100. Your capital fund is coming at 100. For these many years, you have to charge a depreciation. How that organization can do it legally and accounting wise? Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Income expenditure account, and for the past period, retrospectively we have to calculate the depreciation, and the depreciation amount will be deducted from the capital fund.
Brilliant. It means even if anyone has not charged a depreciation till date, please, there is no harm. It will not affect your income expenditure. Reason, income expenditure is for the year, You are not charging depreciation of current year. You are charging the depreciation of the previous years, last years. And therefore, very simple. First, at least if I forget about the current year, till 2012, if a depreciation rate is, let's say, 2%, I'm assuming 2%. So 100, 2% is 2 rupees. From 61 to 2012, how many years? Let me take a very simple, 1%. 51. If it is 2%, it will not even show in your balance sheet. Asset will be removed. No harm. Just in that year, in notes on accounts, it will come. No harm. If it's 1%, 51 years, so 51 rupees goes here, 51 goes here. For the current year, asset is 49 and fund is 49. As sir rightly mentioned, for the current year, you apply the rate and you can follow it. Simple approach. So there is no harm. I'm just responding to a query which was asked. There were two or three institutions which who have asked this query. There is no harm in that. Next is, I'm just raising major points. Another point was this, jo aapke liye bhi applicable tha, which was asked by some people about revaluation. It is again given in AS-6. Now understand, isme kya likha hua hai, because again it's very important. If your balance sheet is showing an asset of 100, let's say capital fund 100, and due to any reason, any natural calamity, bahut normal hai, right? Due to any natural calamity, this asset is destroyed. Now you cannot charge a normal depreciation, not possible. You have to immediately revalue your asset. Re means repeat. Now let's suppose the new value you will not write yourself, you have to ask the valuer. Roads, buildings, civil engineers are the right persons. Civil engineer batata hai ki iski kya value hai. Let's suppose the value is, this asset is 60. Decrease by how much amount? 40. There's a simple logic. For that year, your asset is decreased. It is a loss. Your AS-6 is charged to P&L account. There was one more query which was asked, sir, still I was surprised, sir, does AS applies to us? Why not? I said yesterday, even one transaction which is commercial nature, AS are applicable. It is. And no organization does 100% charity. At least 1% transaction, one transaction is commercial nature. So AS are applicable. So for that year, 40 becomes your loss. What you can do? There is one more variation which can be possible. Because frankly speaking, P&L account is not applicable to you guys. So you can even reduce it from capital fund. Because ultimately, income expenditure deficit goes to which? Capital fund.
What will happen in case of net value? Because there the asset is
deficit. Very good. What happens in case of net value? In case of net value, it will not even appear. You will just show in the notes to accounts. As I mentioned, a lot of people ask me during the break, sir, if you are following net approach, then one query was, aren't we showing our balance sheet at a lower value? Please understand, we organizations are not supposed to make our balance sheet saleable. Hame bechni nahi hai balance sheet apni, pehli cheez. Second, you can prepare a one note of fixed asset as a separate disclosure. Don't make an entry for that. All the assets at the cost price, write the depreciation, show that these are the actual book values. But actual book values are never same as the market value. We all know it. Because in accounts, we show as per historical cost. Market value might be different. You can show it as a separate disclosure. Then there was a query about this. In this, if natural calamity arises, nothing in the balance sheet, sir, just in notes. That this is the worth. You must have seen, just correct me where I'm wrong. There are a lot of computers. You have charged a depreciation 60%. Am I correct? You have charged a depreciation 60%. 60% means guaranteed in 3 years, 4 years, in your books, computer will be almost like zero. Isn't it? But tell me honestly, does that computer physically available in the institute or not? Available. Those are known as unrecorded assets, which physically exist, but book value is zero due to depreciation. So same here. In this method, in net method, we are not saying ki physically available nahi hai. Physically available hai. But we are saying it has been 100% depreciated because it was funded by the government. Simple logic. So I hope this given query was clear. Isme ek aur point aaya tha, revaluation mein. Sir, this is a decrease. Let's suppose it's a land. This is a tricky point in AS. It's a tricky point. Now if land gets increased, let's suppose you want to increase the value of land, market valuation, and you want to show it at the higher value, your board of governance says, let's go for the revised value. Fair enough. Let's suppose 400 profit. But tell me, does that profit have you received from sale of land? Kya aapne land ko becha hai? Accounts is very, very clear. Everyone knows it. Prudence, conservatism, never anticipate the profit. Is this profit in your pocket? No. They were very, very clear. Any profit will not be taken to income expenditure. Open a separate reserve. RR. Revaluation reserve. You can even add revaluation reserve in your fund also. Because ultimately, all the reserves are added to the funds. So please, this is a major part. If you increase any value of the land, immediately do this. Do this part. So if increase ho raha hai, RR, otherwise P&L income expenditure. So this is an example for revaluation which aapke liye bhi important hoga. If you want to copy, most welcome. Otherwise, I have given it.
Revaluation,
kis? Sir, revaluation, in ke case mein, Uttarakhand mein, what has happened? There were a lot of buildings. Now that building has been destroyed.
Okay.
Right, sir. Ab now us building ki worth is around 10 rupees or 20 rupees, let's say. So, the loss aaya, that loss, you have to show it somewhere.
Okay.
Right, sir.
Compensate that.
Right. Either you can charge immediately to income expenditure, this is loss due to the natural calamity. It comes at debit side. Or, if you are charging as a loss, it's like what? You have revised the value, reason due to some reasons. Whenever admission is there, retirement is there, when some person says, ki, let's bring it to the real market worth. Us case mein sir, revaluation ka permission allowed hai.
Lekin land ka jo revaluation hai, to wo land ka to revaluation almost every year hum kar sakte hain jo...
Sir, maine aapko ye bola ki, you are not doing it, even law never says you do the appreciation.
Yes.
But what I said ki, if your board of governance says nahi, we want to show it on the market price.
Board of governance ko to hum hi log advise karte hain, finance people. कि रिवैल्यूएशन करें ना करें इस इतना रिजर्व में हम दिखा के क्या करेंगे
सर इसमें नथिंग इज रॉन्ग रीजन इफ यू सी इट हियर वी आर नॉट शोइंग एनी इनकम नो टैक्स इज इंपोज्ड
नो
राइट वी आर जस्ट क्रिएटिंग अ रिजर्व एनीवन दिस रिजर्व इज नॉट इन कैश
नहीं डेफिनेटली नॉट इन कैश इन काइंड तो लेकिन रिजर्व बहुत ज्यादा हो जाएगा जैसे ओल्ड यूनिवर्सिटीज के पास जो लैंड है उसके वैल्यू तो फ्यू लैक्स में रहे होंगे जिस समय आज के दिन में इन 1000 crores तो रिवैल्यूएशन करने से वो रिजर्व जो होगा 2000 करोड़ 10000 करोड़ उतना भी बढ़ सकता है 40-50 हजार करोड़ भी बढ़ सकता है
सर आपको पता सर रिजर्व इंक्रीज बाय एनी अमाउंट जब तक रिजर्व्स आर ऑलवेज सब्सटेंशिएटेड बाय द एसेट साइड
डेफिनेटली दैट विल काउंटर पार्ट ऑफ
राइट व्हेन देयर इज नो कैश
एसेट्स
सीए इंस्टीट्यूट हैज आल्सो इशू द गाइडेंस डॉक्यूमेंट ऑन दिस गाइडेंस डॉक्यूमेंट ऑन द रिवैल्यूएशन ऑफ द एसेट्स They are very, very clear. This reserve cannot be used for any purpose.
Sure.
Cannot be any purpose. It is just, they have given it because you know it, when a treatment has to be given in the document, they have to take all the possibility. You are saying it's not possible, but might be in an institute. It comes on top, you have to revise it. And he says, no, we have to revise it. Is there any possibility? You cannot say possibility is zero. It is possible. I am not saying ki legally, रॉन्ग है लीगली अलाउड है आप अच्छे लीगल इसमें क्या गलत है आई एग्री विद योर पॉइंट कि इसमें रिजर्व्स बढ़ जाएंगे
बहुत ज्यादा
सर मैं डिनाई नहीं कर रहा हूँ
ओल्डर यूनिवर्सिटी का पर्टिकुलर आई एम फ्रॉम इलाहाबाद बॉम्बे वगैरह ये पुराने यूनिवर्सिटी हैं तो हमारे तो लैंड रहे होंगे 2 लाख या 3 लाख के आज के दिन में इट मे कॉस्ट 1000 करोड़ 2000 करोड़ अदर यूनिवर्सिटी में भी ऐसे होगा तो रिजर्व काफ़ी ज़्यादा
बढ़ा अभी जो इनका भी डाउट आएगा ना Let me clear this for you. There will be one doubt, sir. Account says historical cost. Now, sir, aapke kehne se pehle I know your question. Sir, wait, no. No. Let me just come to that point. This is the definition of cost in AS-6. Cost means historical cost or any amount substituted by historical cost. It means actual purchased by after 5 years, 6 years, if you have revalued or changed it, then logically it gets repaired. In case of Uttarakhand, AS 28 applies impairment of the asset. Asset is impaired. Users ho chuka hai wo asset. If asset is impaired, then logically you will replace historical cost with a new cost. Take example of this chair. If both the legs are broken and you still show it as an asset, It's useless. It's an impairment of the asset. Impairment means useless asset. You were taking example laboratory equipments. There are a lot of laboratory equipments, computers, which you know are available, but unka market worth nahi hai. Impairment. Books, you're talking about. If you know the books are at present obsolete, immediately charge the entire loss. But problem is, I have not touched that point because AS-28 tha nahi course yahan par session mein. AS-28 banaya isliye gaya hai ki there are a lot of assets which sometimes are not market available. Market mein koi value nahi hai. Still with you, immediately remove it. You can do it. Allowed hai. So, sir, I agree reserves badh jayenge. But my point of discussion here was If anyone asks you to do it, is it legally allowed or not? Legally to hai sir. But ye point hai sir. Sir, I hope total clear ho gaya wala bhi. I was knowing ye point aana hai. Let's take one more thing. I'm just referring you, there was one query, depreciation rates options. At present, three options are available to you, which I know. One is Income Tax Act. Please, Income Tax Act means not only to follow everything of Income Tax Act. You can only use a rate as a guidelines. Companies Act, and there is a National Municipal Valuation Model, which Ministry of Finance and Urban Development has passed it, central government. This is a change in Income Tax Act, Companies Act. If you see the last one, unit of production method of depreciation is not permissible as per MC circular earlier, but now it is permitted. That 5,000 point which I was mentioning to you, I'm not saying I don't know, okay, new format may be given. I'm just sharing the knowledge. Earlier, if you see Income Companies Act only talks about depreciation rate of tangible assets. But now they cover both tangible and intangible. Earlier, there was a rates of tangible assets. Now just see, it contains only the useful life of tangible assets. Does not prescribe depreciation rates. Even they know it. MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, is not a fool that they have removed the rate. They were knowing that everyone was facing a trouble in this. They were applying the rates, assuming that rate applied to all the assets, blindly. Whether it is 2%, we are applying 2% all the furniture. But logically, it should be as per the lives. And useful life, the person knows it. For this useful life, a very good question was asked during the break. Sir, now as an accountant, are we supposed to find out the useful life also of every asset? See, in the real life, accountants are not supposed to do this. This is a task to be done by the engineering department. Engineering department gives you, yes, these are the lives, now you calculate the depreciation. Real life mein ye sara calculation, we only do the calculation, estimation we never do it. Estimation is always done by the valuation department, always. I have raised your point, I hope, right? Income tax, sir, book ka aapka tha point. Sir, I have checked yesterday, books ke rates ye hain, income tax act. They only talks about these clauses. Books owned by SSE carrying on the profession is 100. Books being the annual publication. Annual means jo every year print hoti hai. They are charging 60%. Books other than those covered by A is 100. So logically 4.75 sir mujhe mila nahi. Ek baar check karega abhi. Sir, वो तब था जब old income tax rates are being revised every assessment year. ये rates change हो चुके हैं. 2 or 3 years पहले there was a separate block added for books.
हाँ वही मैं बोल रहा हूँ block of asset. If you go through the block of asset concept, where plant is a block. The definition of plant says under the Income Tax Act, the plant includes books also. So we are following that rate. Plant rate is 4.75 as on date.
Sir, plant ka rate, plant mein a lot of classifications given.
Single shift 4.75.
Right. That's why I'm saying, no, never use it because books are never the concept of single shift. So now there's a separate heading for books.
That's why you were facing problem earlier. So now the rate suggests 100%, 60%, 100%, that is also not acceptable. 100% means in 1 year all my books will go.
That's what I'm saying, ki whenever you go for this, income tax rate are only sort of the guidelines.
Yeah.
Are only the guidelines. Please, yahi problem hoti hai, we say, oh, these rates are given, we follow it blindly. You're right. That's the reason Companies Act has, if you ask me, I have taken a right approach. See the life. Use, take a decision. If you feel it can be used for 4 years, please charge for 4 years.
For books, useful life can never be 1 year, 100% yours, as per the Income Tax Act.
If you ask an academician, they will say it will never. Because in academician, Almira, always you find books, guaranteed. Now, intangible asset. Many people were asking me, especially in the engineering department, I was asking two or three organizations, you guys must be developing some software, patents, copyrights. Then I was asking whether those patents were in the name of the professor or in the name of the institute. I was advised they are always in the name of the institute. I agree, ma'am? Okay. It means like in Three Idiots also, if you take example, then when Amir Khan last seen, all the patents were in his name. So when patent are clearly now given in AS-26. The problem which was discussed was, it is very tough to find out the cost. It is very tough to find out the cost of the patent, copyright, trademark. It's very, very simply given in AS-26, paragraph 44. AS-26, paragraph 44 is clearly given. It says, if we have incurred expenditure on research, let's suppose 5 lakh rupees, and that expenditure only the person who is doing a research will tell you. He will have a proof, his effort, his inputs, everything. And from that research, if a concrete item has been developed which is registered as a patent, registered as a trademark, then you immediately should record in the books. Agar aap record nahi kar rahe, take my words in writing. Record my words, I'm telling you. Day is not far behind jab auditor comment karne wala hai ki why you are not recording intangible asset. Because logically you must have incurred a lot of expenditure. Ab apne expenditure kar incur kiya hai, to guarantee the money must have gone out. It means you are charging entire money as a waste, you are charging as an expenditure, which guaranteed somewhere in the future auditor will raise this point. 100%. Take one more example. If you guys are reading the newspaper regularly, last month there was in the news that State Bank of India is selling the trademark of Kingfisher Airlines, Flying High. Flying High was a trademark. They are selling a trademark. It means that trademark must be registered in the balance sheet of Kingfisher. You take your time after the class, go and check the balance sheet of Infosys, Ranbaxy, all the research companies. They always show the intangible asset, because their major task is only the intangible part, softwares. IBM, go and check IBM. SCL, Apple, iPhones, because that's the research they are doing it. So kindly, my advice will be intangible asset. If you are not recording it, start doing it. Here, income tax may now, sir, to your point, income tax may carry it like 25%. Will you believe AS-26 talks about 3 to 5 years. AS-26 says, this was the impairment which I was talking about. So, aapke liye, aapki balance sheet mein, if you write AS-28 impairment, perfectly fine. No auditor can raise the objection. Intangible asset. If you read the second paragraph, intangible asset below 25,000 can be expense, need not be capitalized. And they use the word can be. They are not saying shall be or must be. It's advice. The higher limit is prescribed to avoid detailed recording and amortization of minor items like software which are generally below 25,000. And if you see the top one, period of amortization will depend on the asset. AS-26 prescribes a presumption of 10 years for the life of intangible. However, in case of item like software, where technological advances will result in quicker loss, a time frame of 3 to 5 years. 3 to 5 means around 30%, but income tax says 25. No one says to follow 25%. No one says. You can use 3 to 5 years. So I have given you two ways. Follow either income tax 25% or given in AS-26, 3 to 5 years. You can follow it. But I can guarantee, especially jitna mujhe pata hai, engineering department mein kaam aata hai, and nowadays in all the institutes, at least you guys are purchasing the CDs. When you're purchasing a CD, it means you have purchased a license. Even license fees which you have paid is an intangible asset. Is an intangible asset. The day has gone jab hum goodwill ki baat karte the. Patent, copyright, trademarks, all are now. You will be surprised. There is one more item given in the intangible asset. Recipes of any of the good cook, because recipe is a unique recipe. And recipes are now being sold nowadays. Even again, it's an intangible asset. So this is again a part which you can have it.